safety for anyone else who wants to go out and shoot and make sure it's legal and a safe zone. For starters, make sure whenever you pick up a gun, assume that it's loaded. Do not point it at anyone, obviously, no matter what, loaded or not. And if it has a safety, make sure you keep the safety on when possible. Also, whenever keep your finger off the trigger, like this, before you shoot, don't put your finger on the trigger.
Some other things on gun safety as well. Keep your barrel either at the ground or in the sky at all times. Don't turn in a crowd with your barrel facing at anybody. It happens a lot. You don't even think that you're doing it. Be careful about that. You don't want to hurt yourself, and you don't want to hurt others. Scott.
Also, some of these guns are very loud. I suggest, and we all suggest, that you wear earplugs. It might look stupid, but trust me, your hearing is worth it for the rest of your life. You don't want to be going deaf because you fired a gun and you no longer have any hearing.
And some kind of safety glasses, either whether it be prescription or sunglasses, some kind of protection for your eyes also.
Anything to add, Chris? Boom!
Well said.
Let's have some fun.
Let's have some fun.
To the left.
I'm going left. Killed it. Lefty. Dirty Perry. Killed it.
Set.
He's in.
Right.
Your shot now,
Dad.
My shot?
Yeah, it's your turn. Who got that one? Steve did?
No, Scotty did.
Scott. Oh. Yeah.
What?
Starts cresting. Ready?
Terry?
Yeah.
Terry won.
You know, the most consistent one's got it.
I know.
Ready?
A little proud of that, boy. This doesn't count. I'm just doing this for giggles. Yeah, counts. Whoa! Yes! Nice!
You got it.
Since we're responsible, anywhere we go, we leave the area we're at cleaner than the way we found it. Of course, we shot off a lot of rounds, a lot of shotgun shells, but we're cleaning up ours and other people from before us as well. We leave it looking better than how we found it. There's Perry and Scott, they've been using the rake, cleaning up a whole bunch of stuff.
Oh, that's over there. How clean that looks.
Yeah, these are not our shells that they're cleaning up. We already got ours, and we're getting all the ones that other people from before us left. No. Meanwhile, Steve decided to explore the gully below the camp, and he was joined by Perry a short while later. We had seen several abandoned hulks of rusting cars below, as well as a newer model Dodge truck cab. We wanted to see these up close. We also wanted to see if we could find the tunnel entrance to the original work site, which had been sealed up with steel doors 74 years earlier. All we found were tailings from the tunnel dig, which were probably pushed by bulldozer over the original entrance, and the previously mentioned destroyed vehicles.
We definitely hit this with the shotgun a couple times, but the pellets just bounced off.
Oh, and a couple surfboards, too. Go figure. Scotty brought along his potato cannon, which earlier in the day had fired potatoes up to 100 yards away. This time it didn't work out so good.